If you're really looking out for music, if music is what you've always been waiting for, then it is right there at the click of your finger. Hello there, everybody. My name is Paulashree Roy. I've been associated with music since my childhood, and professionally it's been 4 to 5 years. And I've been really lucky enough to be associated with, a few of the finest institutions in India, music institutions, learn from them, and as well as work for a few of the finest institutions. And today I'm here at Shikshak to share my knowledge, also learn from you guys. So yeah, that's it. The first and the foremost thing for the beginners is that they need to have the sense of sur, the sense of tal. So according to that, we have our set curriculums. We have certain exercises that are very important for them to understand what pitch is, you know, what scale is, you know, how the beats work. So all of those things. So we do that through a number of paltas. We have a lot of sargams. We also do a lot of sapats. Right. So with all of those things, and also we use the metronome, we use the digital tanpura that we have to introduce the students with some sense of tal. So yeah, that will be for the beginners. And then coming to the intermediate one. So there we have, like the pitching is very important. We have a lot of vocal exercises, which also concentrates on a few rags. So we introduce them to the rags, and we also introduce them to a few bandishes. And obviously there are a lot of sargams and paltas out there. Now, coming to Rabindra Sangeet, for the beginners, what we have is we have set some songs which belong to the Shishu Sangeet Porjay, and where we have the songs particularly set for the kids. And I'm sure the kids really find that very interesting. And for the, now coming to the professional level as well as to the intermediate level, in Rabindra Sangeet, we have, so the moment you pass on from the beginner's level, we have a set of porjay. So now we don't anymore have set of songs, we have set of porjay, like, Dharma Geeti, Kabo Geeti, or Ritu Sangeet, or Prem Sangeet, or Puja Porjay Sangeet. So according to that, we have set a few number of songs, and then we deliver those songs to our students. And also apart from that, only for the professional people who really want to take it on the professional level, we have some advanced level vocal training, wherein, we concentrate on the technicalities. You know, you'll see there's always a difference between amateurish singing and professional level singing. So here we concentrate on your breathing pattern, your pitch perfection, your modulation, your voice modulation, your voice flexibility. So all of those things come into account when it's taken on the professional level. Yeah. There is, so anybody beyond 6 years, because I believe that, till 6 years, it's time for the kids to actually listen to develop their ears, so which can be actually very much done at home. So yeah. Above 6 years, anybody can take the lessons. Anybody who's interested in learning Rabindra Sangeet or learning Hindustani classical music, or if you want to take it on a professional level, we are also delivering the advanced level vocal training classes. Moving on to the syllabus, let me first move to the Rabindra Sangeet curriculum. Now, like I told you already, so children below the, from the age of 6 years old to 13 years old, we have a set of Shishu Sangeet, wherein we have a lot of interesting songs like Aaj Dhaner Khete, Amader Bhoy Kahare, a lot of those songs there. And above that, like anybody beyond 13 year old, so we have these we have sectioned it out according to the parjais. So when I say parjai, it's the subsections of Rabindra Sangeet, right? So where we have Dharmo Sangeet, we have Prem Sangeet, Ritu Sangeet, Bhanu Singer Padaboli. So all of those things come into account. And also for you know children above 13 year old to adults, we also deliver the theoretical classes wherein you know they get to know more about Rabindra Sangeet, where they get to know about the works of Rabindranath, because he has obviously written a lot of Giti Natya and Nritya Natya, right? And there is a lot of background to all the songs. So yes, even those lessons are imparted to the students above 13 year old. And now coming to Hindustani classical music. So here what we have is we have a lot of, you know, sargam, akar, and then we have, like I told you, this we develop on the sense of tal, right, the rhythm pattern. And then we have rags. So the main rags that we focus into is Ragyaman, Bhairav, and then Bhupali, Behag, right? And then we have sargam geet for each of these rags. And then we also have the bandishes. And also for a little bit of advanced students, we also do teach them a few ghazals and some light classical songs. And now finally moving on to the advanced voice training module, right? There it is all about, you know, how do you take it to a professional level from your amateurish level, right? So we have focus on your breathing pattern and its nuances. And then we have, you know, how to pitch perfect your voice. And then it's very important that you know your resonators, your vowels, you know, synchronizing with rhythms and beats. So yes, all of those things, your voice modulation, your voice flexibility, all of those gamut of your, you know, voice comes into account in that particular section. I'm following any particular gharana over here. So for Rabindra Sangeet, although if any of the students, they are interested in, you know, sitting for an exam, they can figure out the board that they want to be associated with. And we can figure out the syllabus. And obviously we can, you know, prepare for the songs and that student can anytime sit for the exam. And that depends on the student completely. And also the same goes with Hindustani classical as well. And for the advanced voice training, there's no exam as such, because that's a continuous learning process, I guess. Yeah. Most important thing that really matters when it comes to singing is, you know, how well you're singing on pitch. Because I think that is the most important surme gana jisko hum bolte hai. So to develop that, there are a lot of exercises that we go through. And once your pitch is developed, there are also some exercises, like I already told you, there to, you know, build your breathing more profound, and also for your voice flexibility. So yeah, those things are, I guess, you know, the essence of every person who sings, because you, without your pitch, without having a proper breathing pattern, without having the right sense of beats, it's very difficult. Yeah, so those I would say are the priorities. Yeah. To hi-fi an instrument, it's just a simple tanpura and a harmonium that would do. And also, you know, just a basic tanpura would do for the beginning. Because tanpura has the whole gamut of all the notes. So yeah, it's just a tanpura and a harmonium. As far as the hour of lessons go, I would recommend maybe 1 hour per week. That is one class per week. That should be sufficient. Now, coming on the practice on the student's end, that depends on the student's ability to pick up on something. So I don't really go with the hours of practice. I rather go with the, you know, the perfection that one student attends. So if it takes 2 hours for you to attend the perfection, well, you have to dedicate that 2 hours every week, every day. If it takes 4 hours for you to get that perfection, you have to dedicate 4 hours. And if it is just a ziffy or in half an hour, you know, so as per you go. But at the end of the week, what I would really look forward is how well you have come up with the exercise. My medium of instruction can be English. For Rabindra Sangeet, obviously, it has to be Bengali. And for the Hindustani classical, it can be either Hindi or English or Bengali as well. Number one is that the student should be well connected on the internet and should have either a laptop or an iPad or any of the mobile devices for that matter. And the musical instrument, that is the tanpura and a harmonium. Yeah, that's all. So when we start with our classes, whether it is, classical or it is Rabindra Sangeet or the vocal training. So the first and the foremost thing is that we start with a few warm-ups. Now, when I say warm-ups, the vocal warm-ups like, saying out om. So, for example, we have resonators, right? When we sing, it's not just our throat that we sing with. We use a lot of our resonators, like we use our chest voice, we do use our throat, we use our head voice. So all of those things need to be woken up. Like, for example, when we are asleep and you're suddenly, told to wake up and go for a run, you cannot do that. You need to warm up first. Your body needs to warm up. And the same goes with our voice as well. So before we start any kind of anything, to do with music, the first and the foremost things are the warm-up exercises. Once those are done, and there are a couple of warm-up exercises, there is om, there is the lip trills that we do, we have the tongue trills, and then we have a lot of exercises in the Karaj that actually opens up a lot of your resonators. And then we move to, if it's a Rabindra Sangeet class, we move on to the songs. And if it is a classical class, then we move on to the respective exercises or the bandish or whatever, we are supposed to do. And now, let me concentrate on the Rabindra Sangeet class first. So if it is Rabindra Sangeet class, then what we do is we take up a song. Now, many a times what people think is that, when you're learning a song, it's just that, the teacher will demonstrate the song to you and then you just pick up the song and you're done with it. But that's not how it works here. So here we actually pick up the song. We read the song a couple of times and we try to understand, what the song is meaning to say. It's very important when it comes to Rabindra Sangeet, the lyrics are so deep and so meaningful that it is very important on the student's part to actually read the lyrics and try and understand it in a more deeper sense, right? So we actually first, for the first 15 minutes, or 10 minutes, whatever, we first discuss about the lyrics of the song, what it is trying to say, right? And then we move on to the picking up of the song. So if you want, I can just sing one or two lines of the song. So this is how we go line by line with each song, till the time the student has really picked it up well. Yeah. So typically the class goes in this pattern. Yeah. In case of Rabindra Sangeet especially, if the student wants to take up any exam under any board, so if he or she figures out which board and what is the syllabus, then obviously we can prepare the students for the exams, because once we have the list of songs and the list of, the practicals and also the theory part of the examination, right? We can always prepare the students for the examinations that he or she wants to take up. And the same also goes with Hindustani classical as well. And again, for the professional vocal training, there is no exams as such. So in these two cases, Rabindrasangeet and the Hindustani classical lessons, yeah, obviously, if the student figures out board he or she wants to get associated with and also figures out the syllabus, we can always prepare the students for the exams. Yes. Now that completely depends on the student's, you know, skill set. Now how well the student is picking up on things, how much of practice one is putting up, you know, back home. So it depends on all of those things. But in an average, we can say that it takes minimum around 6 to 8 months for one to start performing. Yeah. Yeah, so like I mentioned, there is this advanced level vocal training, right? So where we actually focus on the technicals, the technicalities of, you know, singing in a professional manner. Yeah, so that is one thing that I do apart from teaching Rabindrasangeet and Hindustani classical. If you're really looking out for music, if music is what you've always been waiting for, then it is right there at the click of your finger. So no more thinking now. It's time to act. And so let's just get going. And one thing that I can really assure you is of a beautiful musical journey ahead. So get in touch and let's have a beautiful journey together. Yeah.